The next one is Opportunity Finder. It looks like a product database. There are roughly the same categories here, but what is happening here? Here we're searching a little bit differently. We're not searching for a specific product as we found a blanket. And we're searching for a product category, the keyword. Let me show you. For example, let's select a few categories here. Sports and outdoors, tools and home improvement. What do we see here? There are filters on the right side. What filters are there? Average monthly units sold. How many units were sold on average per month? These products have at least 800 sales in these categories, for example. Average monthly price, for example, a minimum of 22. Monthly search volume. We will see how many searches per month this keyword has. How many searches are done per month related to this keyword? Let's specify 8,000 minimum. Search volume trend. How has this search trend been going over the last 30 and 90 days? Does it go down in percentages, for example, a minimum of 10% of trend goes up, or a maximum of 10 or a minimum of 50? That is, we don't want to see products that have grown super much. We don't want to see some super trending product because maybe we're not interested in it. We want more stable products. We will specify a maximum of 1%. It's a volume trend. The next one is niche score. This parameter shows how many points Jungle Scout gives to this niche, from 1 to 10. For example, 10 is a great chance to sell in this niche. 1 is not the best. Heavy niche. You can initially take good niches. 10 minimum to put. Again, this is done by a robot and doesn't take everything into account. But often when you see the niche score 10, if you see it at all, there may be a good product. This is a calculation based on competition, according to different criteria, and the higher the better. Let's make a minimum of 5, for example. Competition means how strong our competitiveness is. Let's do it from low to medium. It's all done by a robot. If sometimes it says very high competition, it may still be a good product, but let's make an average one here. And seasonality, very high, very low. Let's do a very low, medium. Include exclude keywords, let's leave it empty. And click exclude top brands, Nike and Apple, for example. We don't want to see it. Let's click search and let me show you what happens. We found 48 different keywords, for example, Pit Vipers. I don't even know what Pit Vipers is. Maybe it's some keyword or it's a brand name. You can look at Amazon, for example, Pit Vipers. I got it, Pit Vipers sunglasses, yes, it's brand. Sometimes brands will appear here, but I advise you to look for keywords. For example, high power laser pointer. It's not a brand. This is some laser that points somewhere. This is the keyword. Here he does not issue a product, but a keyword, and many different keywords fall under our criteria. For example, weighted hula hoops for adult. These are hula hoops that girls or men twist and pump up, I don't know, their muscles, for example. And that's a big keyword. We see weighted hula hoop. This is a hula hoop with a weighting. What does it mean? Again, this is not a product. This is the keyword. We enter some niches that Jungle Scout gives us. And there are many different niches here. What else we will see inside here? We will see the category in which it is located. You can click search on Amazon. How many units were sold per month? The listings in this category have 5,800 sales, the average selling price, and the number of searches per month. 30-day trend. How much has this product trend risen in the last 30 days? For example, it has been increased by 5% here. And for 90 days, it rose by 16%. Competition very low. Niche score 9 means a good chance to sell. This is a big category. There are many different toys here. And again, don't forget, this is just an algorithm. Here is what's interesting. Hula hoops for adults weight loss has risen a lot. Perhaps because of the pandemic. People have started to get fatter, and the demand for this product has grown significantly. More people are looking for this product and want these hula hoops. And Pit Viper sunglasses. This is a brand. Pay attention to the percent of searches. What else can we see? You can get monthly information if you click weighted hula hoops. For example, how the sales of these keywords have been going for 2 years. For example, 400 sales were here, 229, 511. We're looking at 2019. We see that the trend is not dying, and it's fantastic. According to this graph, you can understand what is happening with the trend and where it is going. Sometimes it will go down, sometimes it will go up, and sometimes it will go steadily. In summer, sales rise. We see this in 2020. You can see statistics for a year, for 2 years. What do we see next year? Average price for a specific time. I do not know why it shows only from October to September. Perhaps 2 years is only in Jungle Scout's professional plan. The bottom line is that the price here is about the same. It doesn't fall, it even rises a little. This is good because if you see that the graphs are going down, the niche is getting cheaper and cheaper and competition is becoming more and more. This is not good. Search volume is how many people are searching for a product. For example, in weighted hula hoops for adults, we see that a few people were searching for it. And here, boom, explosion. And it's not so good because we see that before there were low searches. Perhaps this trend will pass. Maybe the whole TikTok is buzzing with these products now. Then it will fall, which shows that it is not very good. I don't like to see this when there is some jump and at other times there was no jump. Here we see seasonality. It says very low. The indicators didn't change much during the year. There was a rise because of the pandemic. Now it jumped up a lot. Again, I don't know why. Perhaps in winter they start to twist these hula hoops more. And the top products in this category can be viewed. Just see these top products. How many sales they make per month, revenue, prices, the number of reviews, when the product appeared, and so on. You can click and see this product on Amazon. And so, you can search for products through the Opportunity Finder. This search is not for a product, but for an opportunity to sell products through some keywords. And again, approximately, we indicate the price of the product and the number of searches per month, and so on. That's all. If we liked some filter, we can save it and load it. Next, we'll look at the Jungle Scout extension for the Chrome browser. And there, we will understand more deeply what we see in the product. We'll talk about it. There is also an extension for searching, but we will do this at the end of this lesson. We have reviewed product search and research.